Now we're going to look at a proof for the bottoms-up method for factoring a trinomial in the form ax squared plus bx plus c when a is not equal to 1 and a, b, and c are relatively prime, meaning there are no common factors. Now the bottoms-up method is a way to factor a trinomial when a is not equal to 1 by factoring a trinomial when a is equal to 1. We'll start by verifying that our trinomial is factorable. To do this, we're going to let a equal m times n. We'll let c equal p times q. And we'll let b equal the quantity mp plus nq. So if we were to try to factor this trinomial using the trial and error method, we know it would factor into two binomial factors, where the first terms of the binomial factors would come from the factors of mnx squared. Let's let this equal mx and this equal nx. And the second terms of the binomial factors would come from the factors of pq, so that the sum of the inner product and outer product would be equal to the middle term, or in this case, the quantity mp plus nq times x. So using the factors of pq, we'll use plus q here and plus p here. Let's check this. Notice the outer product is mpx, and the inner product is nqx, giving us the middle term. So this verifies that this trinomial is factorable. So now what we're going to do is factor this using the bottoms-up method and verify that the binomial factors would be the same. So to factor a trinomial using the bottoms-up method when a is not equal to 1, we're going to write this so that a is equal to 1. So we're going to replace the leading coefficient with 1, and then we'll replace the constant term c with a times c, or in this case, mnpq. So that would give us the trinomial 1x squared plus the middle term stays the same, the quantity mp plus nq times x plus, again, we're replacing this constant term with a times c, which in this case would be mnpq. Now the next step in the bottoms-up method is to factor this trinomial with a leading coefficient of 1. So this will factor into two binomial factors. The first terms of the binomial factors will come from the factors of x squared, which will be x and x. And now we want the factors of c that add to b, or in this case, the factors of mnpq that have a sum of mp plus nq. So let's use plus nq here and plus mp here. Now remember, this is not the same trinomial, so the next step in the bottoms-up method is to divide the constant terms of the binomial factors by the original value of a, which in this case was mn. So we're going to divide this by mn, and then divide this by mn. And now the next step in the bottoms-up method is to simplify these fractions. Notice here we have a common factor of n, and here we have a common factor of m. And now here's the reason why this is called the bottoms-up method. We're going to move the simplified denominators to the position of the coefficient of x. So we're going to move this m up to here, so we'll have mx plus q, and then we'll move n up to the position of the coefficient of x here, leaving us with nx plus p. So again, now we rewrite this as mx plus q times the quantity nx plus p. And this is the bottoms-up method for factoring a trinomial when a is not equal to 1 by changing it to a trinomial when a is equal to 1, and then dividing the constant terms of the binomial factors by the original value of a, simplifying, and then moving the denominators up to the coefficient of the x's. And notice that the binomial factors here and here are the same, proving that the bottoms-up method does work. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.